The infectious disease has ravaged banana plants across Asia, Australia, the Middle East, and Africa, and has been recently confirmed in Colombia. TR4, for which there is no treatment, kills plants by disrupting their vascular systems. The only way to contain the pathogen, once a plantation is infested, is to destroy all of the plants and take the farm out of production for many years while trying to prevent the spores from escaping in runoff. Senior Research Officer in the Ministry of Agriculture, Ms. Hannah Romaine, says the disease can and not only strikes at bananas, but close relatives like plantain as well.
We recognize the threat. We have been working very assiduously in ensuring the exclusion of this disease into the country. So we have been working with various stakeholders, international organizations. Of course, we are aware of the importance of bananas, I should say, and its contribution to food security. So the ministry has been taking urgent and immediate action to prevent the entry of this disease.
Some measures taken include requesting all travelers to declare all agricultural items, contacting the ministry for the importation of all plant material, sensitization workshops with various stakeholders and regional and international agencies.
We have been working with OISA, which is a Latin American organization for plant health. We've been working with the action plan to assess St. Lucia's readiness for this disease. So we have been earlier this week, we have set up a National Emergency Disease Committee as well as an Emergency Task Force. Okay, very shortly we'll be convening a stakeholder consultation to inform all stakeholders of the importance of the need to be alert.
St. Lucia's banana industry in previous years has suffered as a result of black sigatoka disease. The banana is one of the world's top five staple foods, and about 100 million tons of bananas are produced annually in nearly 120 countries. For the DBS News World, I am Sheffield Gillard.